Hey, what's up? John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got this question from Alan about, and he says that he's feeling discouraged. So he says, good evening, John. I need your advice on a project that I'm working on. I'm currently developing a vaping app. Which, if you're not familiar, it's like e-cigarettes, right? At least that's what I understand. But I've noticed there are already a plethora of vape apps in the Google Play and App Store. This is pretty much a one-man show as far as development goes, as I am working on this on my own for both Android and iOS. Should I even bother continuing this project? So, Alan, I gotta tell you, if you ever come up with a totally original idea that no one's ever done before, you let me know, because in all of my life as a software developer, I've never come up with a totally original idea that no one's done before. In fact, if you do come up with a totally original idea that no one's ever come up with before, you should probably lay off the LSD a little bit, because honestly, like, everything under the sun has been done before, right? So here's the thing. So it's kind of good news, right? Because again, if you have an idea that no one's doing, it's probably not a good one, or it's just batshit crazy, right? So to be totally honest with you, right? So the thing is, like, it's good that you have competition. It's good that other people are doing this, but that shouldn't discourage you from doing it. Otherwise, you're never gonna do anything with your life if you're always like, well, someone's better than me, or someone has already done this thing. The world is so big that there's so much room for competitors, in whatever space that you're doing. So unless you're like a huge giant, like, you know, Apple and Google, you know, they're fighting for the market share of the, you know, you don't want to come into that space and build a mobile operating system. Okay, I agree with you there. But for other things, the market is so big that you can get enough customers, especially as a one man show. That's easy. I mean, how much money do you need to make off of your app, you know, to make a good living, or to make money from you? Maybe you need, like, 10,000 customers. That's not a lot of customers, right? So what I'm saying is basically go for it. Don't worry about the competition. And what you can do, so to give you some practical advice here, is look at the other vaping apps that are out there in the App Store and look at the reviews, especially the 3-star reviews, and see what people are saying that needs to be improved with them, and then build something better. Like, take what they're doing and find those things. The 3-star reviews are gonna give you the most honest feedback from people, because they're not total fanboys and they're not just haters, right? They're in the middle. They're giving real honest advice. Look at that and see how you can improve, because if you can build your app that's better, or also focus on one thing, right? You know, there might be a lot of vaping apps out there, but can you do one thing really, really well, better than anyone else, so that you can be the best at that one aspect of the app? I have no idea what a vaping app entails, but anyway, I'm sure you would be in a better position to figure this out. So don't be discouraged. There's always gonna be competition. In fact, it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's a good thing. It means that other people have that same idea, and that's probably a good idea. So best of luck, Alan, and hopefully this advice helps you. If you've got a question for me, just email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and I'd be happy to answer your question. And if you like this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Take care.